Hello and welcome to the Leaflet. Today we are talking to Fuzail Ayyubi. Fuzail, so the contention now is that whether somebody, you know, can use a public park for a religious festival. So can you just take us through the case?
Some people who are performing Mata Ki Chowki, which is a form of a prayer, for 3-4 hours every year for the last 30-40 years, and they were doing it in a public park. Mm-hmm. And this year when they were going to set it up, the municipal corporation said that you can't do that because there is an NGT order. So you have to, this year we will not allow you. So they went to the NGT saying that as far as this particular park is concerned, we have been doing it for this long. And secondly, there is an order which is in our favor, in fact, which says that we can perform Ramrila and some puja, which is an annual feature, in certain parks. And this is one of those parks. So therefore, please permit us to do it. We are not doing anything new. It is doing it for 3-4 decades. The NGT somehow rejected that. And they said that no. I had a junior, Pushkar Sharma, from my native place in Sitapur. And he was doing it there at the NGT. And he came to me and I filed a civil appeal saying that please permit me to do this. So this matter came up before Justice Nariman. And Justice Nariman and Indu Malhotra. So I put all these things before him. And then he said that, but how can you do it? Because this is a public park and it's a government park. So, and since we are a secular state, how will you be permitted to do that? But I said that, see, I'm not doing anything new. And I have the NGT order which says that once in a year, puja and Ramlila I can do. So then he said that, okay, how that is possible? Then he said, what I do is that I refer it to the Chief Justice of India and saying that it, of course, raises an important, he said, that it's a great constitutional question that whether public parks and public places, government-owned land, could be used for religious purposes or not. So since we are a secular state. And that's how he referred it to the larger bench. Since my name was flashed, and then people thought that since I have a Muslim name, so I will be against arguing it. So I don't know how that came. And somehow, but then so many tweets, and then one very infamous guy on Twitter, he said something, and then there was some 1,000 retweets. When this clarification was given by others and by me, and then he, of course, deleted whatever tweet he did. And then Alt News came out with this article, and then I think Quint also wrote an article on this, that no, please, we have come to a point wherein even if a person who is a lawyer, his name happens to be something, then you start believing that no, he will be arguing against a particular religion if he belongs to a different religion. So these things, have, because this is something which is absolutely abnormal. The normal was the culture then we came from. I come from a place, Sitapur, a small town in UP, wherein my father used to be representing as a patron as far as Eidgah committee was concerned, and as well as the Ramrila committee was there. And the Ramrila practices used to take place at my residence. Now today, when name flashes, then you have people coming forward and saying that, oh, you must be arguing against that. The fact of the matter was I was arguing in favor of that.
Fuzail, you also went to meet, some of you went to meet Mr. Gandhi, Mr. Rahul Gandhi of the Congress Party. And there was again a barrage of misinformation and misreporting that happened over that event. So do you see any links between, the sort of the problems that you faced while representing Jyoti Jagran Manch and the meeting, what happened subsequently?
Without confirming anything, one newspaper takes this. And this next day, the defense minister, who just cannot read the Urdu newspaper, was flashing an Urdu newspaper saying,
we've heard from the president of the Congress Party. And this is not somewhere heard somewhere between two friends or anything. It's come out in the Daily Inqilab, a copy which I'm showing here. It's very clearly reported that the president of the Congress Party has said that Congress is a Muslim party. Sri Rahul Gandhi, the president of Congress Party, as reported here, has said, Congress is a Muslim party.
And then the next is the Honorable Prime Minister himself said about this. Mm-hmm. And then a series of ministers who said about this. Not only fake, but this is absurd on the face of it. Then Rahul Gandhi that day said that as far as Congress party is concerned, it is a very old relations with the community. Mm-hmm. And why do you think that the Congress party is not with you? We are with you. Mm-hmm. The same manner we are with the Dalits, the other downtrodden and underprivileged. So don't think that we are not with you. We are with you. And like others, nothing more, nothing less. And he used the term nothing more, nothing less. And this was it, which was being distorted. And distorted, or rather presented, was a fake news. And then look at the way it has been carried by the highest functionaries of the government today. What was the idea? The idea was again to create that rift. One thing important out of that conversation was that somebody said to Rahul Gandhi, कि जब जब मुसलमान कमजोर होते हैं तब तक कांग्रेस पार्टी कमजोर होती है टू आंसर दिस राहुल गांधी सेड नो जब जब मुसलमान कमजोर होते तब तक कांग्रेस पार्टी कमजोर नहीं होती बल्कि जब हिंदू मुसलमान का रिश्ता कमजोर होता है तब कांग्रेस पार्टी कमजोर होती है and that is the essence.
I think that's an interesting note to end with. It's not just a community's relationship with oneself, but intercommunity harmony, Hindu-Muslim relationship that after all define the status of democracy and the state of democracy in India and in other places. Thank you, Fuzail, for that very interesting conversation, and keep watching the Leaflet.